entrance to my store. Now get out of here. Good grief. Every Christmas Eve, these church groups come and sing right in front of my store. Now get out.
Merry Christmas.
What was that?
Merry Christmas.
I would have a Merry Christmas if some of these people would come in here and buy my things instead of just blocking the entrance. No.
He needs a little Christmas, don't y'all think so?
All out the holly, put up the tree before my spirit calls again. Fill up the stocking, I may be rushing things, but deck the halls again now. All out, glory, dear little Christmas, Christ is very near.
Now, no touching.
Mom,
no touching. Kristen, you said yesterday you wanted horseback riding lessons for Christmas.
But I want this!
Well, I don't know where you learned to throw a tantrum like that. Now, Katie, please stop. Y'all go over here and just look around a little bit. Don't touch and be nice. Sir?
Yes, madam.
Could you tell me how much that little brown bear is?
Oh, you're not going to believe this, but that bear is on sale for just 5 more minutes.
Oh, great. Would you mind holding one for me?
Certainly.
And I can be back in about an hour.
Certainly,
all
certainly.
Right, thank you so much. Katie, get out of those sacks. Kristen, put it down, babe. We gotta go. No, we're gonna be late to rehearsal. Come on. Let's hurry. Come on. We gotta hurry. Come on. Let's move.
Satisfied customers and a big bank deposit for me. It just doesn't get any better than that. Hey! Hey, bum! Hey, get out of here! What are you doing sitting in front of my store? Go on! Move on down the street before I call security. Oh, hello, sir. Is there anything I can do for you?
Oh, we'll come back later. Thank you very much.
Excuse me.
Yes, ma'am.
Excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
I know it's late. I understand that. But I have been all over this town searching for a particular doll.
Which doll is that?
The Wanda Wet Wet.
The wonderful Wanda Wet Wet doll. Yeah, the doll that wets and weeps and burps and throws up. It's the most disgusting toy. We sold out of that a long time ago.
Oh. Mm. You know, I wouldn't give almost anything for one of those dolls.
What'd you say, madam?
I said I would pay almost any amount of money for one of those dolls.
Well, you're not gonna believe this. I happened to keep one back under the counter.
Can I have it?
Well, it's going to go at a premium price, you understand. $299, but here it is. You want it?
I'll take her.
I knew it. There you go.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, I'm so excited. She's just going to love it. Oh, I'm so happy, happy, happy.
Hey, Jenkins, get the rest of the Wanda dolls out. I think we're going to sell them all tonight.
You want them all?
Yep. I have never seen Christmas Eve sales this good. I think we'll stay open till midnight.
But, Mr. Dickens, it's Christmas Eve, and I want to spend some time with my family.
Jenkins, spending time with your family costs me money. Now get in there and call them and tell them you're going to be late. I can't do this without you. Good grief. Now, let's see. I just love counting my money. Ones, fives, twenties. I love the hundreds the most. What's that sound? Oh, no. These carolers have been up and down this street 3 times in the last hour. Get out of here! Tree and get out of here. Why is it that every song about Christmas has angels in it? I mean, who has ever seen an angel anyway? Only angels I was ever interested in was Charlie's angels. Timmy. Well, hi, Timmy. Did you come by to help me put out some sales brochures?
I can't tonight, Mr. Dickens. I ran all the way to get here before your store closed so I can invite you to come with me to church tonight. We're having our Christmas Eve play, and I'm going to be an angel.
Oh, no, that's all I need. More angels! Oh, I was just listening to some loudmouth angels just a minute ago.
Mr. Dickens, they asked us to bring our family, and you know my dad doesn't live with us anymore, and my mom has to work tonight. Do you think you could come with me?
What? You're asking me to go to church with you, son? Oh, no, 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 I couldn't do that. Why, we're staying open till midnight. No, I couldn't go.
But Mr. Dickens, Christmas is the most special time of year. Doesn't Christmas mean anything to you?
Let me clue you in on something about Christmas, son. It's the time of year when everybody tries to be nice to each other, but it doesn't last. No, it's all right for little boys like you, but us grown-ups, we know better. No, you may dream of candy in your stockings, but I dream of dollars in my drawers.
I'm sorry you can't come with me to church tonight, Mr. Dickens, so I better give you your gift now.
You got a gift for me? I don't have a gift for you.
That's okay. I don't expect anything. Mom says gifts are free. I'm just glad you're my friend.
Well, thanks, son.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Timmy. What is this little pamphlet? The Real Meaning of Christmas.
Dear God, you know how much I like Mr. Dickens. He's a little confused about Christmas, but I know you can help him. Talk to him in a way that he can understand the real meaning of Christmas. Amen. See you, Mr. Dickens.
Goodbye, Timmy. Well, look at you. You must be looking for the tuxedo rental place, Tux R Us. It's right down the street there.
I'm not looking for a place. I'm seeking a person.
You're not from around here, are you?
No, as a matter of fact, I'm not.
Well, what are you doing here?
Mr. Dickens, I've been requested to come here and help you understand the true meaning of Christmas.
How did you know my name?
I don't.
Don't what, lady?
I don't know your name.
I'm not talking to you.
Well, who in heaven's name are you talking to?
Well, him right there, can't you see him? The clown dressed in white.
The only clown around here, Buster, is you.
No, I'm trying to have a conversation with this gentleman right here.
Mr. Dickens, you are the only one who can see me or hear me.
Who are you?
I would never give you my name.
No, idea. No, lady,
who
I think
are
I'm...
you? No!
I just wanted to explain... What you're doing, you're driving customers away from my store. Now, who are you?
Mr. Dickens, even if I told you, you wouldn't believe me, but I've come to take you on a very important journey, and it's time we'd be on our way.
Are you some kind of kook or something, coming in here bossing everybody around? Who put you in charge?
Like I was saying, Mr. Dickens, you wouldn't believe me even if I told you, but I have much to show you and much to tell you. It's time we be on our way.
Wait a minute. I can't leave my shop. It's Christmas Eve. I've only got the one clerk, and he's a nitwit. He couldn't do anything by himself. Hey, where are you taking me? What's going on here? Wait. Hey, this is strange. Now, I don't know what you're doing, but I'm going to figure it out. Where are you taking me, and who is she?
We're in the town of Nazareth. And this young lady's name is Mary, and I have a very important message that I must give to her. Now, Mr. Dickens, take my traveling hat and cane and stand right over there and listen.
I don't know what's going on here.
Hail, favored one, the Lord. Be great.
child, please tell me, how can this be? I'm still a virgin. What will my parents say? And what about Joseph? Can I really expect him to stay?
About the virgin birth all my life, and I know most tall tales do have a little truth in them.
But Mr. Dickens, this is the most glorious news ever revealed to mankind. It's not just a story.
Wait a minute. Where are we now? This doesn't look like the same place.
It's not, nor is it the same time. You see, it's about 9 months later, and that young lady and her husband have made the long, hard, tiring journey to the village of Bethlehem.
Oh, Bethlehem, I've heard of that. Look at this. Now I know what they're doing, they're selling their wares. I can identify with that, but it's so crowded. What's going on here, the Hebrew Super Bowl or something?
Yes, or something. You see, a Roman emperor, Caesar Augustus, has issued a decree that all people...
I know, I get it. And when Caesar talks... people listen, right?
Right. So, you see, Mary and Joseph have come here to Bethlehem to be counted.
But where are they gonna find a place to stay with the town so crowded and all? I mean... know, if I had lived back then, I could have capitalized on that situation. Yeah, I sure could, all right. In fact, to tell you the truth, the only person in this story of yours that I can even identify with at all is that innkeeper. Oh, yeah. He was a man after my own heart. You know why? Because he knew how to make money! The glorious night in Bethlehem. There's commerce in the air. My inn is filled with paying guests. Each room is booked full fast. I feel just like a child again with candy in my hands. But shekels are much sweeter to any businessman. And if I had one wish to wish, I know it might sound funny. I'd wish for one more room to rent for just a little more money. Just a little bit more. Just a little bit more. Who needs friends and family when it's money I adore? Just a little bit more. Just a little bit more. How much is enough, you ask? Just a little bit more. Oh, this is fun. Now the people have come to Bethlehem so Rome can count their noses. They squeeze us, tax us, oy vey! They would have done the same to Moses. But I've never had a better friend than Caesar, don't you see? But now they all need room and board, and I'm the man they need. And if I had just one more bed, I would not hesitate. I'd sell it twice for thrice the price and charge them double rate. Just a little bit more. Just a little bit more. Who needs friends and family when it's money I adore? Just a little bit more. Just a little bit more. How much is enough, you ask? Just a little bit more. Please don't think I'm greedy. I'd love to help.
The rooms are all full, and it's late, and I'm going home.
No, we're staying open till midnight.
But all the rooms are full.
Look, let's shove some things around out in the stable and make room for one, maybe two more people. Hey, you two over there. I got room for you. It's right over there. It's going to be a banner night. You see those two young strangers? I'm on a roll. I've rented them my stable and a manger.
Just a little bit more.
Just a little bit more.
Just a little bit more.
Just a little bit more. How much is enough, you ask? But it's money. Wow! Just a little bit more.
Just a little bit more.
How much is
I was that innkeeper somehow.
More than you know, Mr. Dickens. Absolutely more than you could possibly know.
Oh, well. Let's get back to that story. Something about a baby. Whatever happened to that baby?
Yes. You see, Mary's baby was born that very night.
Oh, yeah. If my memory serves me correctly, the news of that birth was first shared with shepherds, right?
Right you are, Mr. Dickens. Right you are. If you'll look in that field over there to the left, you'll see those chosen to receive this most glorious announcement.
Oh. Huh. I don't suppose you were there, too.
Why, sure I was there. All of heaven's choir assembled together in honor of that special birth. It was a beautiful starlit night. It seemed that all of creation focused their attention on those fields outside of Bethlehem. There was a divine anticipation as we waited to herald the good news.
What good news?
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which shall be for all people. For today in the city of David, there has been born for you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord.
Wow, that was very good. You did that nicely. Sounds like it was some night. Kind of wish I'd been there.
Mr. Dickens, you are there.
What do you mean? Okay, now I don't understand something here. Explain this to me. If this baby is so important, why was he born in a place like this? I mean, animals eat out of there. This place stinks.
All part of God's plan, Mr. Dickens. The prophet Isaiah, 700 years before the birth of this baby, gave us these words: "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and he shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, and Prince of Peace."
That's fine, but you haven't answered the question. Why was he born in a stable?
For two reasons. First, because he came as a servant. And second of all, because there was no room for him in the inn.
No room? You mean nobody back then would make room for this savior of the world?
That's right, Mr. Dickens. Remember the innkeeper? In over 2,000 years, things haven't changed very much, Mr. Dickens. But that night, some did make room.
Thank you.
just a baby. He's a king.
A king? Where is his crown?
His crown is a crown of suffering.
And his kingdom?
His kingdom, Mr. Dickens, his kingdom is in the hearts of men.
Well, there you go again. I tell you, I don't understand you or him.
Yes, down through the centuries, there have always been those who did not understand him or his kingdom. Even as we speak now, there are those who would seek to kill him because they view his kingdom as a threat. But yet, Mr. Dickens, there are others who are still making their way to find him, to worship him, and to honor him with their gifts.
What kind of gifts could you bring a king he wouldn't already have?
The gifts these men are bringing show they understand what his kingdom is all about. For example, by giving him the gift of the myrrh, that which is used in preparation for burial, they acknowledge his sacrificial death.
Death? You mean to tell me God would let his son die?
All part of God's plan, Mr. Dickens.
Oh.
You see, because of Jesus' death on the cross, he has earned the right to be the center of attention in everyone's life, including yours, Mr. Dickens.
No, no, no! Now stay away from me!
I was a seeker for a light in a dark world. I look
watching me now.
The eyes of Texas are upon you. Welcome back to good old Longview, Texas. Mr. Dickens, you're home.
All right, all right. So you got me back to today. What year is it?
It's been 2001 years since the birth of the Christ child. And look around you, Mr. Dickens. People are still celebrating his birth.
What are we doing in here?
Welcome to Christmas present. Now, Mr. Dickens, you'll have to hold your voice down just a little bit because we're inside a church.
A church? You didn't say anything about taking me to a church. I hope your halo's on tight, because with me in here, the roof's probably going to cave in.
Now, Mr. Dickens, hold on just a moment. Hold on. We're here to join Mobberly Baptist Church in their Christmas pageant.
No, I ain't joining no Baptist church. They get you inside, they make you sign a card, and you go on paying for the rest of your life.
Mr. Dickens, it's not about money.
Well,
it's
look at this money. Place. Somebody's got to pay for it. It's not going to be me.
Mr. Dickens, now look, here's a couple of seats for us right over here. I want you to sit down, and I want you to see the difference Jesus makes in the lives of people who make room for him.
All right, get in there. Staring at me, lady. It's not my fault we're late.
He is Jehovah, God of creation. He is Jehovah, Lord God Almighty, the balm of Gilead, the rock of ages. He is Jehovah, the God that he left thee.
on people, didn't he?
Yes, he did. For those who make room for him.
So the difference between the shepherds and the innkeeper is that the shepherds made room for him, but the innkeeper didn't.
That's right, Mr. Dickens. The shepherds made room for him.
Well, why don't more people make room for him?
Mr. Dickens, most likely for the same reason that you don't make room for Jesus. You see, you're just too busy. You're too busy selling toys, too busy making money, too busy being so concerned about anything and anyone else except the Christ of Christmas. But Mr. Dickens, you're not alone. People pass your store every day whose lives are so filled with everything else, they simply have no room for Jesus.
Faces filled with care,
room for Jesus. And look, I don't make snap decisions either, but someday in the future, I'm going to make room for Jesus. I am.
Mr. Dickens, you are in the future.
What is he doing? Jenkins' store? No, no, no! Make him stop it! Make him stop it! Take it down! No, 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 no! I gave my life for that store!
That's right, Mr. Dickens. You gave your life for that store.
Okay. If this is the future, what happens to me?
In the Bible, it says, just as man is destined to die once, and after that to face judgment. Mr. Dickens, have you any idea of what heaven is like?
Golden streets, I guess? Pearly gates? I don't know. What is heaven like?
Oh, Mr. Dickens, not the half has been told. Not the half. You see, for over 2,000 years since his birth, the Christ of Christmas has been preparing a place for those who love him, for those who have made room for him in this life. You see, it's not about gold or silver or pearl. It's about a personal, intimate love relationship with the Christ of Christmas. Mr. Dickens, you see all these people around you? They are spending eternity with the Christ of Christmas because they made room for him.
What? There's Clifford. He had a store down the street from me. Wasn't much of a businessman, never would stay open on Sunday. I guess he made room for Jesus, huh? And there's Miss Almack, my third grade teacher. So I guess heaven really is a real place with real people in it.
That's right, Mr. Dickens. For those who made room for him.
That means Emma's here. I want to see Emma. She was a wonderful wife. I didn't tell her how much I loved her. I want to stay.
Mr. Dickens, what? I'm sorry, but you can't stay.
No, here. I want to.
No,
don't,
I'm sorry.
Don't make me leave.
You can't stay, Mr. Dickens.
No, don't.
I'm sorry.
Emma! Emma!
Thank you.
There's still time to make room for Jesus. There's still time to make room for Jesus. Where's that pamphlet that Timmy gave me? The real meaning of Christmas. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. God, you know, I haven't been one to pray much. But I want to start now. I have made such a mess of my life. Just full of emptiness. But I want to start over. I want you to come into my life, into my heart. And make me a new creation. Forgive me of my sins. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Grief and pain, or why sorrow?
it took me so long, I had to call my wife and tell her that I was going to be late.
Late? What for?
Well, you said we was going to be here till midnight.
No, 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 no. This is Christmas Eve. We're going to celebrate the birthday of Jesus. In fact, I want to do something nice for your kids. How many kids you got?
7.
How many boys?
5.
How many girls?
4.
Yeah, well, you take all this stuff and you just tell them Merry Christmas from old Mr. Dickens, all right? Oh, one more thing. That sweet wife of yours, I want you to get her something real nice. Will you do that for me?
I'll do that, yes, sir.
Okay. Oh, one more thing. Tell her that you love her. Will you do that for me?
I can do that.
All right. Thanks. Oh, one more thing. Here, get some Slim Fast for yourself. Merry Christmas. Yeah. Timmy, Timmy, do you still want me to go to that church play with you?
Sure, Mr. Dickens.
Oh, good. I wouldn't miss it for the world. Let me just lock up this cash register. Oh, this is going to be so much fun. I can't wait. We're going to the... Wait. Wait just a second. I thought you told me that I was the only person that could see you.
That's right.
Well, what's all this with the boy?
Mr. Dickens, I was sent here because of Timmy's prayer for you.
Oh. You are a little angel, aren't you, son? Merry Christmas, everybody!
Good night. God bless you. Merry Christmas.